Welcome to Read Your Heart Out. I'm Ann Forrester. Today's story is about a mischievous rabbit who finds himself in a heap of trouble. It's the tale of Peter Rabbit by Beatrix Potter. Let's begin. Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits. Their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived with their mother in a sandbank underneath the root of a very big fir tree. "Now, my dears," said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning, "you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor. Now run along and don't get into mischief. I am going out." Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the woods to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns. Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane together to gather blackberries. But Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. First he ate some lettuce and French beans, then he ate some radishes. Then, feeling rather sick, he looked for some parsley. Around the end of a cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor. Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees, planting out young cabbages. He jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake, calling out, "Stop, thief!" Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten the way back to the gate. He lost one shoe among the cabbages and the other among the potatoes. After losing them, he ran on 4 legs and went faster, so that I think he might have got away altogether if he had not unfortunately ran into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his jacket. It was a blue jacket with brass buttons, quite new. Peter gave himself up for lost and shed big tears. His sobs were overheard by some friendly sparrows who flew to him in great excitement. Mr. McGregor came up with a shovel, which he intended to pop on the top of Peter, but Peter wiggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind him. He rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under each one. Then Peter sneezed. Achoo! Mr. McGregor was after him in no time. Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. Also, he was very damp from sitting in that can. After a time, he began to wander about going. Lippity, lippity, not very fast, and looking all around, he found a door in a wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth she could not answer. She only shook her head. Peter began to cry. Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became more and more puzzled. He came to a pond where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish, sitting very still. Peter thought it was best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin Bunny. He went back toward the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe, scritch, scratch, scritch, scratch. Peter ran underneath the bushes, but presently, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed upon a wheelbarrow and peeped over. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned toward Peter, and just beyond him was the gate. Peter got down very quietly and started running as fast as he could. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner, but Peter did not care. He slipped under the gate and was safe at last. Mr. McGregor hung up the little jacket and shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him until he got home to the big fir tree. He was so tired, he flopped down upon the nice soft sand and shut his eyes. His mother was busy cooking. She wondered what he had done with his clothes. It was the second little jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in 2 weeks. I am sorry to say that Peter was not very well during the evening. His mother put him to bed and made him some chamomile tea. Then she gave a dose of it to Peter, one teaspoonful to be taken at bedtime. But Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. The end. The tale of Peter Rabbit is just one of many tales about animals by Beatrix Potter. I hope you enjoyed the story. Thanks for reading with me. Until next time, find a good book and read your heart out.